We from the Soft Robotics Lab at ETH Zurich present high-frequency capacitive sensing for electrohydraulic soft actuators. The need for compliant and proprioceptive actuators has grown more evident in pursuing more adaptable and versatile robotic systems. Hydraulically amplified self-healing electrostatic actuators, called HASELs, offer distinctive advantages with their inherent softness and flexibility, making them promising candidates for various robotic tasks. A commonly used type of HASEL is the piano HASEL actuator, consisting of a flexible, non-stretchable shell partially covered in a symmetrical pair of electrodes and filled with a dielectric liquid. When a high enough driving voltage is applied to the electrode pair, the electrodes zip together, pushing fluid into the remaining portion of the pouch, which results in a contraction of the actuator. The electrodes on a piano HASEL actuator act as a variable capacitor, the capacitance of which is dependent on the electrode's position relative to each other. This means that the capacitance will change as the actuator deforms. As such, HASELs are able to provide feedback about the deformation without the need for external sensors, which allows for more low-cost, power-efficient, and space-efficient designs that can be used in untethered and variable robotic applications. Here, we can see one such application, which we will discuss in detail in a few minutes, in which we use HASEL actuators to provide motion capture for the knee and hip joint. To enable more variable applications like this, it has become highly relevant to develop sensing methods to estimate the state of the HASEL actuator in a wide frequency range, using only internal measurements of voltage and current. A common technique for the self-sensing of HASELs is based on superimposing a low-voltage sinusoidal sensing signal onto the high-voltage driving signal applied to the electrodes of the actuator, and measuring changes in the low-voltage signal caused by the change in capacitance between the electrodes as the actuator deforms. The current state of the art is a miniaturized capacitive sensing circuitry for electrostatic transducers as proposed by Li et al., in which superimposition and measurement of the low-voltage sensing signal occur on the low-voltage side of an electrostatic transducer. This facilitates the use of low-voltage off-the-shelf components, reducing both cost and form factor of the circuitry. However, when used with piano HASEL actuators, this method experiences a phase lag between the true displacement and the estimated displacement at actuation frequencies of 1 Hz and above, resulting in a drastic loss of sensing performance at higher frequencies. Furthermore, the proposed method shows distortions in the estimated displacement when high enough driving voltages are applied, using a miniature high-voltage power supply. To address these issues, we propose a new HASEL design, coined the Frog HASEL, FHASEL for short, in which an additional pair of electrodes is added to a piano HASEL on the opposite side of the electrodes used for high-voltage actuation. As shown here on the right, as the actuator contracts, the capacity between the additional pair of electrodes decreases. We then apply a low voltage signal, exclusively across this additional pair of electrodes, to notice this change in capacity. This pair of electrodes will be referred to as the sensing electrodes. One major benefit this design offers is that in our case, the sensing electrodes are the low voltage level. This allows us to take a direct measurement of the voltage drop of the sensing signal over the sensing electrodes with a low voltage off-the-shelf components. Furthermore, we can implement a low side current sensor by placing a resistor in series with the sensing electrodes and measuring the voltage drop over said resistor. We use the acquired measurements for two different methods of estimating the displacement. Firstly, the voltage method, which estimates the displacement by directly mapping it to a change in the voltage measurement caused by a filter response without any additional calculations. Secondly, the impedance method, which uses both voltage and current information to calculate changes in the complex impedance of the low voltage sensing electrodes. The setup for our experiments involved mounting the HASEL vertically on a custom rig. The top of the HASEL was securely fixed on the rig while an interchangeable weight was attached to the bottom of the HASEL. Both the miniature high-voltage power supply as well as the sensing PCB were connected to a DAQ. The ground truth for a displacement was captured using a laser point sensor. Our measurements were mapped to the ground truth employing an offline third-order polynomial mapping approach. The estimated displacement generated by using the voltage method shows a close overlap with the ground truth displacement for both a step actuation signal at 0.5 Hz as well as for a sinusoidal actuation signal at frequencies ranging from 0.5 Hz up to 5 Hz. Here on the top right, we visualize the normalized root mean squared error and the phase lag between the displacement estimation and the ground truth displacement for both the voltage method and the impedance method. While our method performs similarly well at very low frequencies compared to the state of the art, as soon as we approach the 1 Hz mark, we can see a decrease in error of approximately 70%. This decrease is even more drastic at 5 Hz, where we find a reduction of approximately 90%. And this despite our setup using a miniature power supply. Comparing the performance of the voltage method to the one of the impedance method, we observe a trend of the voltage method performing better at a frequency of 3 Hz and below. Meanwhile, the impedance method performs better at higher frequencies. We believe the cause to be that the performance of the different methods is affected to a different degree by different sources of noise. This results in one of the two proposed methods being more suitable for different applications than the other. As observed, the estimated displacement shows good overlap with the ground truth, even at actuation frequencies of 8 Hz, with an error of only around 6%. However, there is a drastic loss in performance when increasing the actuation frequency from 8 Hz to 10 Hz, which increases the error from 6% to 14%. This trend continues as we increase the actuation frequency to 20 Hz, where we observe an error of 26%. The cause for this can be found in the fitting plot for an actuation frequency of 20 Hz as shown here. We observe a clearly defined hysteresis effect of the ground truth displacement as a function of the voltage measured across the sensing electrodes. Due to this, our third order polynomial mapping approach starts to fail at frequencies of around 10 Hz. To address this, we propose a dual third-order polynomial mapping approach, which considers whether the actuator is contracting or relaxing at the time the displacement estimation takes place, as visible here. This drastically improves sensing performance, bringing the error at 20 Hz actuation frequency from 26% down to 10%. Now, while our design is already quite small, it is still only able to measure the displacement of a single actuator. In certain applications, like soft wearables or prosthetic devices, extra importance is placed on the design of circuitry with a small form factor. This becomes an increasing challenge when multiple Hazel actuators are used in the design. In a step towards the miniaturization of the sensing circuitry of Hazel actuators, we propose a circuitry that allows the previously presented voltage and current measurements to be performed for multiple F Hazels using minimal additional components. For this, we switch through an array of different Hazels using two multiplexers which are placed between the Hazels and the sensing circuitry as shown here. This allows us to use the same measuring components for all Hazels for which you want to estimate the displacement. The design offers a great reduction in form factor of the required sensing circuitry with the trade-off of a reduced update frequency per Hazel. We demonstrate the use of this circuitry with a variable application which tracks the joint rotation angles of the knee and the hip joint of a VR user in a 2D plane and transmit them to your user's virtual avatar. While this alone is achievable through the use of commercial sensors, the use of F-Hazel actuators demonstrates their ability to provide displacement information in potential variable applications where Hazel actuators are used for force generation, for example, force feedback. The following characteristics of our proposed sensing circuitry are what allows this application to be portable and untethered. 1. The ability to use a single compact sensing circuitry to measure multiple actuators. 2. The ability to ensure accurate sensing performance even when using a miniature high-voltage power supply. 3. The ability to measure changes in actuator displacement caused by external tensile forces. And 4. The space-efficient and power-efficient nature of capacitive sensing without external sensors. As shown here, after a quick calibration, this setup using our design allows for actuation and real-time displacement sensing of four actuators, using hardware that all fits into a small box mounted on the hip. In summary, we introduced the F-Hazel, as well as two miniature low-voltage capacitive sensing circuits, which take advantage of an additional electrode pair to enable accurate displacement estimations during high-frequency actuation with miniature power supplies. We validated the displacement estimation performance at actuation frequencies up to 20 Hz, showing a drastic increase in performance of up to 90% at higher frequencies compared to previous works, as well as proposed a dual third-order polynomial mapping approach to address a hysteresis effect occurring at frequencies of 10 Hz and above. Furthermore, we proposed a miniaturized circuitry that utilizes multiplexers to measure multiple F-Hazel actuators quasi-simultaneously, using minimal additional components. Finally, we demonstrated an untethered and wearable application that uses miniaturized circuitry to both actuate and sense the displacement of multiple F-Hazel actuators to provide real-time motion capture of a VR user's hip and knee joint. We thank you all for your attention and encourage you to read our published work.